Hi there, I'm Shane Spiers, and welcome to another edition of the Performance Brief, where we give you one breakthrough business idea in just 5 minutes. My guest today is Jamie Cunningham. Jamie, a very warm welcome. Where are you today? How are you today?
I firstly am in Northern Victoria, Australia, and I'm doing very well. It's towards the end of my day, but it's been an awesome day.
Brilliant. For those of you that don't know him, Jamie is an author, business coach, owner of multiple businesses, husband, father, and mountain biker. He is driven by the desire to help business owners grow themselves through growing their businesses. He has worked with over 300 clients directly and many thousands more through his speaking and writing. Jamie's philosophy around growing businesses is based in time-tested principles and fundamentals. He is not a believer in secrets or silver bullets. Jamie, the title of our interview today is The Power of Clarity and How to Get to It. And we have 5 minutes for the interview. Are you ready?
I'm ready. Let's do it.
Great. Let's set my clock. So let's just start. Why is clarity important?
I think it was Stephen Covey that said, begin with the end in mind. And you know, it's all about really knowing what you want. It's very hard, you know, to create anything, any outcome in life or to generate results. There has to be a plan in place. You have to be very intentional about what you're going to do. And it's very hard to decide what to do, at what direction or what level of magnitude if you're not sure where you want to end up. And so while everyone's heard of goal setting and knowing where you want to be, getting the specifics and getting the tangible vision in your mind of where you want to end up makes it very easy to say yes or no to different things. And when you're brainstorming a list of possible ideas to generate, you know, some kind of result, you can very quickly prioritize and assess which ones are going to move you there fastest.
So as a business owner, what do I need to be clear about?
It's a great question. And the typical, I guess, immediate response would be things around your business, but we actually reverse engineer it a little bit and really ask the question, what do you want out of your life? Like, what do you want your life to look like? And how, if you were to map out, pick a time frame, 3, 5, 10 years, whatever makes sense to you, what you want your typical day, week, or even year to look like, whether it's, you know, vacation time, hobbies, business activities, how do you want that to look? And get clear around that first, and then ask yourself, what sort of business do I need to build that's going to give me that, that's right, going to allow me to have that sort of lifestyle? And then, again, depends on the time frame, but we reverse engineer backwards all the way down to a 90-day increment, so you can then have an actionable plan to move forward in a time period that you can be focused on and is easy to manage with day-to-day sort of decisions, but knowing that if you do those things, you're on track to the life that you want to create.
Right. And so what's the process? How do you get clarity?
That is a great question. And I don't think it's something, you know, I'll certainly speak from my own experience and those I've worked with. I'm not sure that you wake up one morning and all of a sudden you've got this light bulb moment, you know exactly what you want your life to look like. I think it's a bit of a journey. Things start to become clear, and sometimes only once you've had an experience that you realise what you don't want, can you start to understand what you do want. And I think certainly to sit down and, you know, ask yourself some of those questions I alluded to at the start, to say what does my ideal life look like, is a starting point. And then to keep revisiting it. And I encourage my clients to do that long-term visioning every 90 days. Perhaps it hasn't changed, but maybe there are a few things now which are a bit clearer, and you start to piece the puzzle together a bit at a time.
Right.
And as things go on, it starts to get very, very clear. Well, it certainly has for me and many clients that I work with. So I know that's not sort of a silver bullet answer, but I think that it just does evolve over time, Shane.
Yeah. So it's a kind of an evolution. And how long does that kind of take, really? Is it just constant?
Yeah, it's constant. I think, look, again, if you sit back and just wait for it to come to you, it may never come to you. It does have to be intention behind it, and you have to sit down and carve the time out to ask the questions and to assess, am I on track, and, you know, is this resonating with me, what feels right? And it does change different stages of life, create different needs and different things that become important to us along the way. So you've got to be open, I think, to seeing those things differently, but always seeking to get ever clearer. How you define that, I'm not sure you can.
Right.
But I think if you're sitting there and you can't work out what is the right thing to start moving forward on, perhaps you're not really clear at that point what you need to, where is you want to end up.
Right.
So, you know, asking things, if we bring it back to the business specifics, asking things like, you know, what size do I want my business to be? What level of profitability do I want it to have? And that can give you sort of a magnitude around maybe the number of people you need to have, and you build a financial model around that. And then you can start to have a look at, okay, who are my other, suppliers or partners, or what do my employees look like? What does my team look like? Those sorts of questions. And it can start to carve out, and you can understand the culture that you want to have, and, perhaps who you want to be, what sort of leader you want to be, what sort of role you might want to have in other areas outside the business.
That's brilliant. We're just coming up to our time, so I'll make sure I get the link in there. It's www.salesup.com.au, and some really great stuff on Jamie's website there, folks. Jamie, thank you very much.
Thanks, Shane.